Hey everybody, what's up? CPA Strength here. Didn't give you the usual intro. Just not feeling it today. Although, this accounting video is going to be an homage to my art history teacher, Betsy, in Lane County, Oregon. I had her for two classes because I loved the class so much. And at the beginning of class, she would say, hey, she's like, it's so crazy out there in this outside world. Let's just turn the lights off, look at some slides, and get lost in this art history. And at first, I was like, this bitch is crazy. But I just started to really look forward to that class and just, you know, just zone it all out, man. So, just like the weight of the world has been bringing me down. Anyways, that's not for this video. This is accounting for beginners. This is my classic series. This is number 87. I can't believe I started this series about 2 years ago. I never thought it would be what it would be. If you want to see the earlier videos, here's the best playlist in the world. It's an accounting playlist, but it is the best playlist in the world. So let's get into this. Before we start, anyways, here we have DCA Lure. This will really help you if you take one thing away from my videos or any video. I want it to be the DC Adler debit credit, asset draw expense, liability, equity revenue. I have a bunch of videos. These would be in the positive form. Let's see, do we have a yes, we have a negative in this one, so we're gonna be fine. So let's just get into this one, right? Number 87, paying a liability. Widget Incorporated pays back $7,000 in shareholder loans. Okay. Well, you guys want to fill it in? Do you guys think, or what would you do first? Just saying what I would do. Is there money? Is there cash involved? Widget Incorporated pays back $7,000. So you got to put your hat on, and you're we're Widget Incorporated. So put your hat on, and then. So this is us. So it's like, this is us. This is the biz, this is us. So we pay back someone $7,000. So do we have more or less money? Well, we're paying someone back, because this is us. So we have less money. All right. And what is cash? Cash is an asset. And so here's the asset right here. If it was going up, if it was increasing, it would be a debit. It is decreasing, so it's a credit. Cash decreasing is a credit. So go over here, 7,000 checking account. Sorry, I use cash and checking account kind of like simultaneously the same thing. And that is, that's an asset. Decreasing. That's why it's a credit. Now let's get our debit. What would our debit be? Our debit's gonna be, well, we know it's gotta equal 7,000. Because debits and credits equal always. Debit's just with the left side, credit's just the right side. What did we do? Why did we give away that money, or why did we have less money? We paid back $7,000 in shareholder loans. Alright. We had a shareholder loan. Let's look at our books. Yeah, there was a there's a chart in our chart of accounts for shareholder loans for $7,000. That's on the books. because we're doing this. So if we look on the books, yeah, there's a loan for it's called shareholder loans, right? Let's see. Let me look. Loan from shareholder. That I'm looking. I just looked at the chart of accounts. So loan from shareholder. We already have that. Yeah. So we're reducing that. So anyways, a loan from shareholder. Well, it's a liability account. Loan from shareholder because we're liable to somebody. We are reducing the amount we owe to somebody because we're paying them back. So, if increasing liability is a credit, decreasing is a debit. So it's going to be a debit, $7,000, loan from shareholder. Loan from shareholder. And that is a liability going down. So as you see this journal entry, they're both are decreasing, asset and a liability, so they're reversed from here. Anyways, next board.
Okay, this looks good for government work. I skipped, because it was just too long, and I felt like I skipped, I did, I believe, 14 of these Widget Inc. Videos with our ongoing business, with the chart of accounts and general ledger board. So I did a whole year with that, and I think you can get the gist of it. I feel like our time, your time would be better spent just going over journal entries and how it affects the income statement and balance sheet, because that's kind of the mid stuff, and that's the chart of accounts, journal ledger. I don't know, I just feel like that's too long. And anyway, so we're gonna nix that board unless I get comments like, oh, I want that board back, I really liked that second board. I'll bring it back then, because if you guys want it, I'll bring it back for sure. What happened? Okay, income statements, period. The period's from 01-2016, January 1st, 2016 to 2-28-16, February, the end of February 2016, a period. We didn't do anything here this month. But we don't know that. But for this period, we just have service revenue of $40,000. No expenses yet during this year. So we have the net income of $40,000. Because income statements, revenue minus expenses equal net income. The $40,000 net income at the bottom of the income statement travels through to the bottom of the balance sheet. Net income $40,000 right here. Now, what did we do? We had the checking account. Reduced by, now let's go to the balance sheet. The balance sheet is one certain date, one certain point of time. And our point of time here is February 28, 2016. Now, the checking account got changed. It got reduced by $7,000. And that's an asset. Now, assets equal liabilities plus equity. Also, there was a loan from shareholder account here for $7,000, but I just erased it. And now some people might want to leave a zero here. I just like it off. If there's no value in the account, I personally, it's just a personal thing, like to wipe it off the whole entire balance sheet. You know, a balance sheet, it balances, right? You have your assets over on this side, and then you have your liabilities and equity on the other side, right? So you took away $7,000 from here, so we're lower over here. So you would have to take away $7,000 on this side, on the liabilities and equity, which we did. We took away the $7,000. We just messed with these two. So on the balance sheet and income statement, we just messed with the assets and liabilities, and we reduced them by 5,000. We paid loan for shareholder back, because the shareholder in this small business was just me.
So I paid myself back because we finally got a lot of cash in the account. Oh my God, I'm on this side. This side feels so weird. I can't, sorry. But we finally had like $50,000 cash and we were like, oh, we can finally pay myself back. So that's what we did in this one. You know, this was supposed to be a real short video, but I just keep talking. For me, I've just been having a real, really, really, really hard week this week. Let's just say I've gotten really, I have a lot of feelings that I didn't have before. From age 15 to 35, I found drugs and alcohol and I just went as deep as I could because I don't like what goes through my head. You know, I don't like myself. I never have. So yeah, I don't know. So obviously this is gonna get cut out because this is just trash. I don't even know where I was getting at that. I've just been having a really tough week. I just stuffed all my feelings down because I just had negative thoughts ever since I can remember. Ever since I was, you know, 4 years old, my first thoughts are, I hate myself. I'm stupid, and I hate myself, and everything I do is wrong. And those are my first thoughts, and that's really never left me. Unless I would get so drunk or high that I wouldn't remember that, and then I would get too drunk or high, and then I would start crying because I hate myself. And it's just, I'm a mess. We know this. But I pretty much stuffed all my feelings in for 20 years. Now in the past 4.5 years, these feelings are here and I don't like them at all and I don't know how to deal with them and I don't do a good job of it. So, yeah. Deuces!